If you'd rather be anywhere than stuck indoors arranging insurance, why not give Walker Midgley Insurance Brokers a call today? We've been established for over 40 years, so our friendly specialists can sort the right cover for organs, steam vehicles, modelers, clubs and societies, as well as vintage tractors and much more. We believe we can beat your existing quote. Call us today on 0114 250 2770. Walker Midgley is part of the Towergate Underwriting Group Limited, who are authorised and regulated by the Financial Conduct Authority. Cover is for UK-based customers only.
Broadcasting from our studios in the UK. Heard around the world.
Automatic musical instruments.
On app, on Alexa speakers and online. Tuesday Night Live.
With James Dundon.
Hello, evening, welcome. See, this part of the year used to be boring, but now, thanks to events like the Milton Keynes Organ Festival in a couple of weeks, we've got the Cotton Fair Organ Day now happening at the Grange coming up, and the weekend just gone, on Sunday, another new event for this end of the year at the Weald and Downland Museum, a new organ festival. The Weald and Downland Museum is where they film The Repair Shop, so we did bump into David Burville, resident expert who's been on the show restoring many items. We caught a word with him on the programme tonight. Also, you'll hear four exclusive tracks of White's Mamoth Gavioli after its recent restoration by Meayers Organs. It gave a lovely Sunday afternoon concert with a full printed program, a lovely souvenir for many enthusiasts, and over 100 people I counted gathered there to listen and enjoy the instrument. And just have a look at the picture of White's Gavi on our Facebook page. I took a sort of a close-up of the pipework section and it's gleaming, absolutely gleaming. It looks like new. It's quite incredible to see it. So absolutely great. You'll hear four different tracks from White's tonight. Oh, and our instrument of the week is the double roof. A little bit later on in the programme, you'll hear Jan Kees de Ruyter telling us a little bit more about the history of this stunning instrument. It's where we start the show tonight, and the piece is called Minuetto. The double roof, our instrument of the week, starting Tuesday Night Live. Thank you. Isn't that fantastic? Absolutely exquisite. The Double Ruth, our instrument of the week. Hear another track from that a bit later on in the show. We've got a special overture that we recorded in the acoustics of the church in the museum Spielklok in Utrecht, and Jan Kees will tell us a bit more about the instrument. Now, our Tuesday talking point, we thought because we've got David Burville, repair shop expert, on the show, we thought we'd ask the question, what item do you need to book into the repair shop? So what item do you need to book in? David Scott says, my very early cassette of Robert Wolf on the Wurlitzer. I might be able to repair. I've tried repairing cassettes before. I think it's a bit of a no-hoper, David, but we could give it a go. Vicky Rogers has a wind-up clockwork fairground carousel. Sounds interesting. We'll book it in. And Tommy DeLay says, I've got quite a lot of music books to repair, which, yes, don't we all? It's, I've been there. It's a winter evening job when you get the glue out and splice in bits of card and then punch out the holes. It really is a labour of love. Look, let us know what you have to repair. We'd love to hear from you. You can get in touch with the live programme tonight. We're here through till 10. My email is on the website. You just go to mechanicalmusicradio.com and click contact, and you can text or email us from there. Now, we were mentioning the Weald and Downland Living Museum held its first ever organ festival at the weekend. Some really great instruments in attendance. Lovely to see all sorts of shapes and sizes present, some of which I haven't seen before. So really great and good to catch up with some familiar favourites as well, like White's Mamoth Gavioli. It was recently restored by Meayers Organs. I think many appreciative people listening to the concert on Sunday afternoon agreed that it really was sounding absolutely great. And I know many people I spoke to said, look, this was the organ that got me into organs. This is what we used to see on the rally field. And I just think it was the most impressive, amazing thing I'd ever heard. So here it is in its current state after a full restoration from Meayers Organs, sounding wonderful. We'll play you a couple of tracks back to back from it, starting with Miss Elizabeth Brown.
Tuesday Night Live.
Mechanical Music Radio.
Thank you.
White's Mamoth Gavioli, a couple of tracks there after its recent restoration by Meayers Organs. Thanks to Kevin Meayers for sending over these pieces. We'll play a couple more before the end of the show tonight. Now, also at the Weald and Downland Museum at the weekend, we got to catch up with a repair shop expert because that's where they film the repair shop in that barn. Is it this wonderful, what they call a living museum, which is full of these wonderful old buildings. Now, this thatched repair shop barn would have been dating back to the late 17th century. It would have been used for threshing and storage crops, but the barn transformed into the repair shop for the filming period. They were there setting it up for another week ahead of busy filming when we were there at the Organ Festival on Sunday. And we bumped into repair shop expert David Burville, who was there in attendance with his bride and joy, Dorothea, a Dutch street organ, because, of course, he is an organ builder by trade. And on the repair shop, he's got involved in several different projects, including, of course, one of his first on the telly, that pedaling harmonium. Do you remember that fold-up harmonium? He told me all about it.
Yeah, that was quite a wreck when it came in. It looked like Zebedee with springs popping out of it and all sorts. And it was a bit of a head scratcher, that one, I must admit, you know. But it worked out really, really well. And and they was absolutely over the moon with it. But they do throw some wonderful items at us. And I think because we've got such a good team, they can really tackle everything now, you know, which is great. And it certainly tests my skills to the limit, you know. So
it's like you look at the deadlines that some of you experts are up against. It's like they'll come to you with an object, say, I don't know, a harmonium, and they'll say, can we have it ready in 5 days? Well, you'd never do something like that for a customer, would you? It's just impossible. But for telly, you've got to make it happen.
Well, this is it. Yeah. They do give us a little bit more time sometimes, you know. But it's
depending on the item. Do you have to sort of budget the time and then say to them, oh, I need a bit more?
Well, you do, yeah, you do sometimes, you know. But, yeah, I mean, fortunately, it you know, it does work out nicely and we do get enough time. But, no, we get some wonderful things and it's a pleasure, real pleasure to work on the variety of stuff.
Tell us about this particular instrument we're about to hear.
Well, this is a 1963 Vandenbroek organ, 52 keys, and we brought it over from Holland about 3 years ago, and in the time I've totally rebuilt it, enlarged it.
Well, look, we're going to hear it. We've got Dance Ballerina Dance lineup. I'll go around the front. Thank you, David.
Thank you. Take care.
From the repair shop, Mr. David Burville, and here is Dorothea.
Great to hear Dorothea from David Burville, his street organ, which he imported from Holland and has done a lot of work. He's completely rebuilt it and made it into the instrument that it is today. And many people enjoyed that at the Weald and Downland Organ Festival on Sunday, of course, where the repair shop was filmed. They put him right outside the barn, the famous barn, which we saw there in the background. So it really was a great, great location for it. And for those who don't know, because I know we've got lots of repair shop fans tuning in tonight who heard about our show on the internet. Well, David, an organ builder by trade, he originally worked for Church Organ Builders at Brown's, and then he went on to work in Belgium with Johnny Verbeck's firm, world famous. And then he moved back to the UK to set up his own company, which he still does today. He's an organ builder by trade, but on the repair shop, he seems to turn it into anything. I saw him in one episode mending a remote-controlled battleship. He's very resourceful. Absolutely great to have David Burville on the show this evening.
Join me, David Ward, on Mechanical Music Radio, broadcasting to you live from Dublin in Ireland, bringing you the greatest selection of mechanical music instruments anywhere in the world. Every day, Monday to Friday, 4 p.m. until 6 p.m. We've got a jam-packed show for you. We do a trio of rally scene instruments every day at 20 past 4, and at 20 past 5, we do our feel-good three. So join me, David Ward, on Mechanical Music Radio, Monday to Friday, 4 p.m. until 6 p.m.
So why do you just renew your insurance policy for your mechanical organ? I suppose there aren't many of us who list paperwork as our hobby. Get a quote from Walker Midgley Insurance Brokers. Our experienced and friendly advisors can sort cover for your organ and ancillary equipment, public liability, and cover for your commercial vehicle or trailer. Call us today on 0114 250 2770. Walker Midgley is part of the Towergate Underwriting Group Limited, who are authorised and regulated by the Financial Conduct Authority. Cover is for UK-based customers only.
Fun and Games with James. Tuesday Night Live.
Mechanical Music Radio. We'll be right back.
That's great, isn't it? To cap Organ Goliath, and also Walking Back to Happiness on the Pan's Flute, beautiful Dutch street organ, because we play all styles of automatic instrument from around the world. We are Mechanical Music Radio. This is James Dundon. It's another Tuesday night live through till 10. And we have got some fun and games along the way. Do you want a little game? We've done this for the last couple of weeks, the mystery noise, and we haven't had a correct answer. So what I'm going to do tonight is I'm going to let you hear a little bit more of it. And actually, repair shop expert David Burville recorded this himself in his workshop. We have video evidence of said mystery noise to post on our social media when someone gets it right, finally. No correct answers so far. We've had people saying things like, is it counting screws? Things like that. No. What do you think this is? What I'm going to do tonight is I'm going to play you a larger section of the sound. Before I was playing about 3 seconds. Well, tonight you're going to get the full 15 seconds of it. So what is David Burville doing here in his workshop? Any ideas? I reckon you could give that a guess. You know it's in his workshop, so maybe it's something to do with tools, maybe it's something to do with, I don't know, bits of organ that he's got lying around. What is he doing here? This is our mystery noise. I'm getting 5 guesses on the radio next. We'll see if we can get a right answer coming in. So contact us now. If you want a chance of naming what you think he's doing there, yeah? Tell us what you think the mystery noise is. You can text us. You can email us. Just go to the website and click contact.
Text the studio now. 07871 221 511 or email through our website, mechanicalmusicradio.com.
Couple of fun tracks, some up-tempo pieces. You can hear more like that on our happy hour every morning at 9, every afternoon at 3, and every evening at 11. We play some up-tempo popular pieces, you know, stuff that you'll know, like that, a Barry White hit, My First, My Last, My Everything played there on the Cap dance organ Goliath. And welcome to a world of automatic instruments. It's Tuesday Night Live with James Dundon here at Mechanical Music Radio. So a couple more pieces now that were recorded after the restoration of White's Mamoth Gavioli by the Kevin Meayers firm. Kevin sent these into us to play because I know many people enjoyed hearing the instrument without too many background noises and interruptions. They gave a lovely classical concert on Sunday afternoon at the Weald and Downland Museum at 2 o'clock, a printed programme. Lovely to hear as well. Here's a couple more pieces recorded in Kevin's workshop shortly after the work was completed, starting with this, The Conqueror on White's Gavioli.
Tuesday Night Live.
Mechanical Music Radio.
We'll be right back.
White's Mamoth Gavioli after restoration by Meayers Organs. Hope you've been enjoying hearing some tracks recorded exclusively for us tonight. James Dundon on Tuesday Night Live. Now, back to our mystery noise. We've had some messages in, people trying to guess what David Burville's doing in his workshop. Have a listen to this. Any ideas? Shall we get some guesses on the radio? We're going to do up to five here. Let's see if someone gets it right. So in no particular order, at random, all the texts and emails that we've had in, we are going to choose this one. Mike Green. Hello, Mike. Mike says, is the mystery noise a music book being punched? Oh, it sounds like it, doesn't it, actually? No, it's not. Peter Mackett. Evening to you, Peter. He thinks it's winding or tensioning reservoir springs. So you got the reservoir there at the top for the reserve of air. You want to tighten or wind the springs, tighten them up. No, but a good guess, a good guess. We move on. Got another one here from Andrew Rota. Is it winding up a spring? Oh, it's the same as Peter Mackett, more or less. Well, it could be a snare drum spring. No, not a spring. Let's go for another one. So we've done three guesses, haven't we? Two more to go. Will it be another rollover? Here we go. Guess four. This is from Ben Jackson. Is the mystery noise manually setting a register box? You got all your different registers on an organ. Is he pushing it up? Yes, that's it, Ben, you got it. It's gone after 3 weeks. The mystery noise is setting a registration box manually. And we got the video of that, which we'll put on our social media to prove it in a minute. It was a sort of a Gavioli style musical box where it sort of goes up into a hook. And then you've got a bar to pull back to let them all drop down. That is the mystery noise. Well done if you were guessing along at home. Tuesday Night Live with James Dundon, now playing Richard Evans Marenghi. This is a charming instrument, and we saw it at the weekend at the Weald and Downland Museum, where the repair shop was filmed at that new organ festival. Lovely to hear it, and well, it's going to play for you now. Picador. Thank you.
Fun and Games with James. Tuesday Night Live.
Mechanical Music Radio.
Mechanical Music Radio's One Second Song.
Here we go then. Can you get tonight's One Second Song? I don't think you'll have too much of a problem with this, hopefully. It's quite easy. So we're going to play you a second of a song. You've got to tell me what the title is. And it's a well-known piece. So here's your second. Ready? That's all right, isn't it? No problem at all. You let me know if you know the answer. Get in touch now, mechanicalmusicradio.com, and click contact. And on there is the text number and the email for you to tell us what this is. All right, get in touch and we'll reveal the answer at the end of the live show tonight, just before 10.
Text the studio now, 07871 221 511, or email through our website, mechanicalmusicradio.com.
Tune in for something familiar. For something that makes you feel good. Get those toes tapping with Mechanical Music Radio's Happy Hour. 60 minutes of sing-along hits. Every morning at 9, every afternoon at 3, and every evening at 11.
the Grange Musical Collection, based in Suffolk. They're the UK's largest and most diverse museum for mechanical music, with regular public open days on the first Sunday of every month. They're always on the lookout for a new and unique exhibit. Contact in confidence if you have something to sell. Find them on Facebook or visit thegrangemusicalcollection.com. Proud supporters of Mechanical Music Radio.
Tuesday Night Live with James Dundon. Here we are, and we do this every Tuesday night from 9 till 10 p.m. Welcome to all the new listeners joining us, and the old favourites as well. Many people getting in touch with the one-second song answer. Any ideas on this? You better get in touch now, because we'll reveal the answer at the end of the show very soon. MechanicalMusicRadio.com. Just think about what comes next. What's the tune here? Let us know, and the answer's coming up. First, though, another track from our instrument of the week. We open the show with this, and you'll hear this instrument more than any other this week. We've singled it out as something we want to play a lot of. It's the double roof, and this is part of the Museum Spielklok in the city of Utrecht in Holland, a renowned, world-famous collection. And the double roof you can see there in the church, on the stage, beneath the church organ. You'll find out why it's there in a minute. We get to know all the information because we caught up exclusively on a recent visit to Holland with Jan Kees de Ruyter, who told us all about the history of the double roof and how it came to be built. And have a listen to this as he explains it was built by the roof firm at not a very happy time.
The firm of Root in Waldkirch in Germany was top quality instruments. And till the end of the 1920s, the market plunged with the crisis and the invention of jukebox and everything. So they tried to do other things. And we think that they used this organ not really as a fairground organ, but as a sort of concert organ for a concert hall and that kind of things. Yeah. It's not really the power of a fairground organ. Mm. They only made two of them, and in the 1930s the factory went down. So, but this is an organ which is the back case of this organ is an ordinary Root Model 38. Mm-hmm. But there were a lot of additional pipes were put in the front case, mm-hmm. which is now here. That's two cases. That why they called it here for some reason the double root.
Yeah, yeah. Two roof organs together. Even if you look on the side, you can see there's bellows in each case as well. So it's almost like it's independent.
Yes, it's normal case has two feeders, and there's an extra feeder for the first case.
Yeah,
there, and they all front. Go together.
Yeah, incredible. Yeah. And as you say, not a loud instrument, very listenable, and very versatile as well. Just such a selection of...
It has a very good scale. It's completely chromatic for five octaves. And even the reed pipes span three octaves of... more. Mm. Yeah, even.
It's an instrument that was in the dance hall... and then when things had a move around, it's been on the stage ever since. Is there a reason why this instrument was chosen to go on the stage in the church?
It is the instrument which matches the church organ very much in sound and everything.
So. Yeah, so it's a good compliment. Yeah.
Thank you.
That's lovely.
Thanks to Jan Kays, to writer, for telling us all about the double roof, and I hope you enjoyed that classical overture. That's what it was made to play, the classical pieces. You'll hear more tracks from a double roof tonight on the Glenn Thomas programme. He's with you from midnight British summertime. He does his programme from the States for our worldwide audience who want to tune in and enjoy mechanical music. So I hope you can join Glenn tonight at midnight. He's got a couple of hours to bring you the best American band organs and other world mechanical music. He's coming up a little bit later on from midnight. Do join him.
Mechanical Music Radio's 1 second song.
Right, finishing the programme tonight with the answer to the 1 second song. Did you get it? I mean, it wasn't that difficult, was it? You got that? No problem. Come on. What are you complaining about? The fastest finger first was Peter Mackett. Bang, with a right answer. Guido was second. And third was Andrew Rota. Congratulations. Hi to Nick from Hove. New listener to the programme, or at least first time, long time listener, first time caller, maybe, I don't know. Hi, Nick. Also to Ian Tepper, who was late for class. Your apology accepted, Ian. Hi to Matt Lyons, also to David Aldridge, to Bill Warder, to Michael Morris. Thanks for the text. Mark Raven also got it and said even 12-year-old daughter Emily, goddess of a Raven household, have been playing along. Hi also to Mike Green, to Michael Clark up Leeds Way, to Jory Bennett, who's listening. Nice to see you at the weekend at the Organ Festival, Jory. Hi to Rich Levangi, who's listening the other side of the world there in that there America. And then we got Glenn Thomas, of course, getting ready for his show at midnight tonight. Cheers, Glenn. Hi to Bill and Claire, also in the US. And Michael Pumphrey, who gets it. And Newton Williams, who's listening in Australia. Good morning, Newton. He's there the other side of the world, about to hop on his bike off to work. And many others as well. Look, if you got it, I don't know if you did. Hang on, if I play you a bit more. Yes. Clang. And you know, if it's got the big bell on it, it must be for 101 Key Mortier. Taj Mahal, also in Australia. So just as well, Newt's got it right. And the tune, Ain't She Sweet, was our 1 second song. Your organ, Taj Mahal. Ain't She Sweet was our 1 second song. Well done if you got it. And that was Tuesday Night Live. We'll see you same time next week. Meanwhile, Mechanical Music Radio continues 24 hours a day with different shows and different presenters. Always something different to enjoy. Whenever you can, tune in. We're available on app, on smart speaker, and at mechanicalmusicradio.com. Requests next. After 10 o'clock, we do a whole hour of your requests. Mark in the USA, Andrew in Bridgewater, Marmal in Essex, Nick in Hove, all lining up their choices. What do you want to hear? Best get to the website, mechanicalmusicradio.com. and click request. It really is that simple. We'll play what you want to hear next. All right, have a great night.